Well, I'm in my new spot for the day, wearing my high-vis jacket. You can get it at woodboss.ca. And I'm just here for the day. And I'll show you. So I'm working over there. It should be fairly flat today. And the reason I'm here is because my falling partner had to go home, family emergency. He had to go home. So it was a last minute thing. So just to make things work, I had spare gear at camp. So I brought my spare gear out to this block, and I'll put this block in, or work this block for the day. And then tomorrow I'll pack out and go back to my regular block, and I'll have a new falling partner. But what that means is I got my big saw and my big axe and this little wood. So we're packing on this unnecessary extra weight. And we might get fogged out. We're the lowest block out of everybody. And the fog was getting lower. Yes, yeah, dropping, even though the pilot's just saying right now. The weather's dropping. We're good. We're good. We're pretty low. And rush is so low that the bottom of my block joins in with the conventional block. So we can just hike out of the road real easy. So that's it. That's all I was going to say. So I'll see you guys if I can find a big tree. Then I'll turn the camera back on. But other than that, it's probably going to be a pretty small tree day. Oh well, so there she goes. At least I got in here. And if you do have to hike out, if you do get a part day, well, at least I made some money. So that's okay. Oh yeah, so woodboss.ca. It's got a chest pocket that's zippered. And has the inside pocket in the chest here. And it's got the pockets down here. One down here and one the other side. And the hood is removable. Yeah, and it's one of a kind. I designed it myself. Woodboss.ca if you guys want one. Okay, see you later. Okay, so I'm at my bottom line. And I'm cooking. Oh, I think I'll take this coat off. It's a bit wet in the bush, but it's easy walking around. And I got a lot of snags. There's a lot of snags. But it's not even that steep. The ground is gently sloped. It's easy walking around. The bush isn't that thick. And then when I'm opening up here, there's going to be some dumping down the hill. So let's get to work. What I'm going to do is I'm just going to put it on this stump here I made and just film for the next 20 minutes or so. So you can see how I open up and just something different, you know, filming it in a different way, trying it out, see if you guys like it. So, probably gonna dump all this little saplings and stuff down the hill. And there's this bottom boundary right there. And the snags, I'll try and put them sideways or through an opening down the hill and try, because I don't have any opening, so I kind of gotta, you know, fall through the timber where it's safe and get an opening started. And I just gotta remember that the camera is here and I don't fall anything this way and hit the camera, so. Got to keep that in mind. Yeah, I think I'll be all right. I'll keep my jacket on.
Oh, That was limb tie a lot more than I thought it was. That was deceiving. Okay. We'll get a couple more snags, then I'll go limb and top that cedar there. The little one. Okay, so that's just a little start, a little taste of how I start opening up. I had that one hang up, but you see I had a couple trees go down there, and then I had, of course, this one here, went down right in there, and I had one hung up, and went a little bit too much to the right, and it got hung up, and then what you do, you fence post it, because sometimes when you fence post it, you just cut an angle, right? And it geopokes into the ground. You want to get it so when you fence post it, it doesn't geopoke in the ground. And then your next cut, you do like an undercut and then a back cut in a certain way so that it'll, instead of dropping down, it'll pinch in and go like this and then drop down. And then by that time, the center of gravity is shifted over, and it'll now fall back out of your whatever you hung up in, and that's what it did. And it came back this way. So that's a real good, fast way of getting that hang up out. I mean, you don't want to do it in every situation, but a lot of times it works out quite great. And that's what I did. So I can't keep going that way because the line starts to go up the hill like this to the pad over there. So I got to continue on opening up that way. So I can't keep filming. Camera's going to be in the way. But this is my first tank and my fuel's at the pad. So I'll just keep going until I run out of gas. But you see the line, the orange ribbon, going up in a line up there, this. And there's pink ribbon too. I'm not really sure what that means. If there's anything written on here or not. Nope, but we do have, because corner posts are generally 100 meters apart. So that's corner post N1-2. So corner post N1's over there. How small this wood is. I got some natural hang ups, right? Hang up there, another one there. But it's all small wood, so it'll be easy. And a couple heavy leaners. Leaning every which way, a couple that way, a couple one that way. That's good, because if it was all perfectly straight up and down, it'd be kind of boring. But it makes it a little challenging. Makes you so really gotta think and strategize when you get these hang-ups and all sorts of things Mother Nature throws at you. Okay, I gotta get to work. I don't know. I'll turn the cam back on for something. I don't know what, but I'll see you guys here in a little bit. Well, I guess today's a short day. Pretty much all the other crews, all the other guys are fogged out and they're higher than us. So they're pulling everyone off. Even though we're fine, they're pulling us off. I hate that. It bugs me. Like, we're not fogged out. Why do we have to shut down and go back to camp and not make money? Oh, it just drives me nuts. I mean, if the chopper could still get to us and there's guys already in camp that can come out with the chopper if we got hurt, what's the problem? It's totally fine.
I don't know. We were just told to get to the pad because everyone else is fogged out. Like, we're real low. Like, we're like 200 feet in elevation from the road, in the valley bottom. Like, but these hang-ups here, I might get those tomorrow, or I'll just be opening up on the bottom line tomorrow. I don't know. So we'll see. See, look how bright it is. Yeah. That's a bummer. But I don't have to wear my rubber boots anymore. My feet are cooking. I thought it was going to be a wet, rainy day. But it's just cloudy. Yeah, and even then, it's starting to get brighter and brighter. So it happened yesterday. I think it was yesterday, the other day. Super foggy in the morning, then we waited a bit, and then fog lifted, got on the hill, and then by noon, the sun was out. Anyways.